Mental health.
Yes.
As in what now?
That
is what I'm saying. I don't know now. I'm a native doctor.
Mental illness is way beyond just abnormal behavior. You know, it's something that has affected the brain and it's not coordinating anymore. You know, those things haphazardly. Madness, that's all.
My own word is any disease of the mind, and maybe the person is mad there, so this is disease of the mind, yeah.
Not everybody who goes naked or goes eating dustbins is a mad person. There are some persons who might be clean as I am, but they have psychiatric problems. There are some mental problems that are from spiritual. There are some mental problems that have to do with psychiatric brain and all that. So if you go to, you know, first of all, if I'm sick today, first of all, I'll go to medical. When I try the medical way, if it does not work, then I can go to spiritual way, that is by man of God or any other way to see if they can cure me.
We have so many roots so here, and so many people have been coming around and they tested it and they see the type of the root. People are coming from Lagos State, people are coming from Ibadan. People are coming to all parts of this country that know the value of our root, and when they take and they transfer that is a measure that they cure, they are, that is how they use to advertise it in everywhere.
But there is one particular root. We don't have the English name, it is the native name. And the Yoruba name is Asupeyeje Egbo.
Asupeyeje
Egbo. That's the Egbo Asupeyeje. That's the particular root.
What does it mean?
It doesn't have an English name.
Okay.
Then mostly we combine root and herbs. That depends on the power you're having in you. That will determine you curing a mad person.
The first and foremost thing is to see how you can, you know, get that person in chains. And then for me, as a child of God, as a woman of God, I believe that with God all things are possible. First and foremost is to pray.
You want to ask me what should be education response to it? Is first and foremost there should be sufficient knowledge creation. Let people know that it is not spirit, it is not juju, as they will say, that leads to mental health issue. The push and press of everyday living can lead you to the bend, as some people will say. So it's a question of your body chemistry. How it's able to, how you're able to manage your body chemistry to be able to absorb the external stimuli that is impacting on your wellness or otherwise. So for me, education should be able to create an understanding for the general populace that it's something that can happen to anybody if you are unable to manage and control the situation in which you find yourself. And what that simply means is that if we observe that manifestation early enough for a child, a third party has to be able to come in, either to counsel or either to seek for early medical attention or to properly diagnose the cause of that depression that is possibly going to lead to complete mental imbalance. So it should be an issue of mutual understanding, issue of empathizing with whoever is that state of mind, and finding how to be able to help the person. Because if you do not help the person, if you begin to stigmatize the person, you begin to alienate the person, then the situation becomes worse. It begins to become completely disoriented because he does not seem to get sympathy and understanding from the people around him.
If you are not involved, you can be committed. And we're all stakeholders in whatever, be it education, whatever, we're all stakeholders. And we need to be committed wherever you are. Wherever you are. You see, if you don't push something, nobody will push it for you. And why I said commitment is this. If I am given a job to do a particular thing, okay? Instead of making sure that that thing is done properly, I do a haphazard job because I have interest, love for money.